Welcome to my channel. In today's video, we are going to solve one important theorem of DTFT. It's a modulation theorem. Okay, so this theorem, it is an extension of frequency shifting theorem. Okay, and why the name is called as modulation theorem means, so this theorem, it is used to analyze the modulated signal. Okay, so that is in communication system, we are using the process modulation. What is modulation? So that is the information signal is not transmitted directly to the receiver for a long distance transmission. So in order to convert that information, low frequency signals into high frequency signal, we have to mix our information signal with one high frequency carrier wave. So that process we are calling it as a modulation process. Okay, so in order to analyze that modulated signal, we are using this theorem. That's why this theorem name it as a modulation theorem. Okay, so you see, if one discrete signal x of n, the DTFT of the discrete signal, it can be written as capital X of e power j omega. Okay, then this discrete signal x of n multiplied with one cosine signal, cos omega naught n. Okay, so here we are assuming it as this cosine signal is a high frequency signal when compared to this our information signal. Okay, so here this x of n is an information signal. So this information signal is multiplied with one high frequency carrier. This is said to be the carrier. So if you are multiplying these two signal, means that process is called as a modulation in communication. Okay, so if we want to find the Fourier transform of, that is the DTFT of this product, means the answer is that 1 divided by 2 into the spectrum capital X of e power j omega plus omega naught plus X of e power j omega minus omega naught. So what is this X of e power j omega plus omega naught? You know, X of e power j omega is the Fourier transform of our information signal X of n. Okay, then this X of n is multiplied with one cosine signal, means we will get, it is an addition of two x terms. Okay, so what is the first term? Means this original Fourier transform is shifted by the amount omega naught to the left side. Okay, similarly, this is the spectrum that x of e power j omega is shifted to the right side by the omega naught. So the DTFT of the multiplication of this x of n with the cos omega naught signal, it is an addition of this two shifted spectrum. One is minus omega naught amount, another one is plus omega naught amount. Okay, so this is said to be the modulation theorem. So this theorem, okay, so this property is used in the process modulation. Okay, so now we are going to prove this property. Okay, so this modulation theorem you will study in the that is in communication theory paper or digital communication paper, we may use this property. Okay, so we are going to prove this property. So our aim is to, what is our aim? Our aim is to prove that the Fourier transform of x of n cos omega naught n is this one. Okay, so you know, the Fourier transform of x of n cos omega naught n, so it can be written as Fourier transform of x of n, and instead of this cos omega naught n, so we may substitute in terms of e power theta. Okay, so you know, cos theta is nothing but e power j theta plus e power minus j theta divided by 2. Okay, so you know, so in the place of angle theta, which one is there? Omega naught n is there. So it can be written as e power j omega naught n plus e power minus j omega naught n divided by 2. Okay, then here this 1 by 2 is a constant, so you take it outside. So this x of n you multiply with each term. Okay, so that's why the first term can be written as x of n into j omega naught n. Okay, so 1 by 2 you take it as a common. So 1 by 2 Fourier transform of x of n e power j omega naught n plus the constant 1 by 2 Fourier transform of x of n into e power minus j omega naught n. Okay, and you know, what is the Fourier transform of any our signal x of n multiplied with e power j omega naught n? So already we know the answer. We know this answer for this Fourier transform. That is, we studied the frequency shifting property, you know. Okay, so what is the frequency shifting property? Any signal multiplied with one complex exponential signal means the Fourier transform answer is that the original spectrum x of e power j omega shifted by the amount omega naught. Okay, so you see the frequency shifting property. That frequency shifting property already we derived in the previous videos. So you check in the signals and system playlist. Okay, so you see, so this is the frequency shifting property. Any signal x of n multiplied with e power j omega naught n means the DTFT answer is that x of e power j omega shifted by the amount omega naught. Okay, similarly, any signal x of n multiplied with e power minus j omega naught. Okay, e power minus j omega naught n means the x of e power j omega plus omega naught. Okay, so already we derived this frequency shifting property. So according to this property, so here you see, so according to this property in this modulation theorem, so Fourier transform of x of n multiplied with e power j omega naught n. So what is the answer? Capital X of e power j omega minus omega naught. Okay, if plus e power j omega means it is shifted to the right side by the amount omega naught. So plus 1/2. What is the Fourier transform of x of n multiplied with e power minus j omega naught n? According to the frequency shifting property, this can be written as capital X of e power j omega plus omega naught. Okay, so this is the answer for the modulation theorem. So any signal x of n multiplied with one cosine signal. Okay, one high frequency cosine means the Fourier transform answer is that 1/2 the original spectrum shifted to the right side plus 1/2 the original spectrum shifted to the left side by the amount omega naught. Okay, so this is called as a modulation theorem. Okay, so it is this theorem, it plays a very important role in communication system. Okay, while analyzing the digital communication, we have to use this formula. Okay, and the next theorem we are going to discuss about is a Parseval theorem. So this Parseval theorem, so it is especially for the Fourier transform. So already we discussed the Parseval theorem in second unit, the continuous time Fourier transform also. So that is for the continuous time signal. So this Parseval theorem, it is for the discrete signal. Okay, so what is the use of this Parseval theorem means? It is used to calculate the energy. Okay, energy in terms of the Fourier transform answers. Okay, so already you know that is in the first unit, that is the signal classification. So we discussed, we calculated energy of continuous time signal and discrete time signal using the mathematical formula. So what is the energy of the discrete signal x of n? The formula is that E equal to summation n equal to minus infinity to infinity modulus of x of n the whole squared. Okay, so this is the energy formula in terms of time domain. Okay, so this is the energy formula in terms of the time domain. Okay, time domain. If we want to find the energy of the same signal using the Fourier transform answer means, so we have to use the formula is that the energy E is calculated as that 1/2 pi integration over minus pi to pi modulus of x of e power j omega the whole squared into d omega. Okay, so the same answer. Okay, so that is using this time domain formula. So what is the answer we will get? The same answer we will get using this Fourier transform answer also. Okay, so this Parseval theorem is used to find the energy of a discrete signal. Okay, similarly, in the second unit, we discussed the Parseval theorem that is used to find the energy of the continuous time signal. Okay, so if any signal x of n, the DTFT answer is capital X of e power j omega means, then the energy is calculated as that 1/2 pi integration over minus pi to pi the modulus of this Fourier transform answer the whole squared into d omega. So this is the formula to find the Parseval theorem. Okay, so that's all the properties of DTFT. Okay, so this question, the properties of DTFT, it is a very important question. Okay, already I told this question is asked for all years of question paper. So you see, it is asked for 2010 continuously, 2011, 12, 15, 16, 17, 18 and 19. So So you must study this property. Okay, so compulsory. So sometime the question may ask us that is state and prove some that is the following properties like. So if you are mentioning means, so linearity property, it is also, it will come in two time. Okay. That is the time shifting property. It is a very important property. Okay. If they are mentioning means the time shifting property, this frequency shifting property. Okay. This question you see four time, this question will come frequency shifting time reversal property. It is also a specific property. Then differentiation property, it is also two time came. Then this convolution property is a very, very important property. This question, it will come for two mark also in big question also. Okay, so convolution, there are two convolution. This is the convolution in time domain and another one is a convolution in frequency domain. Okay, so all the properties we proved in the previous videos. Okay, so if you want to study means you check in the playlist signals and system, the properties of DTFT, you just refer this one. Okay, again this modulation theorem. Okay, this modulation theorem, it's a very important property used in a communication system. And this Parseval theorem, it is also a important 2 mark question. Okay, so this question is a 2 mark question. Okay, they ask in 2 mark question. So study these properties. Okay, that's all the properties of DTFT. Okay, so in the next video we will discuss the Z transform problems. Okay, so thanks for watching my channel. And keep watching and share this video to your friends. And please subscribe my channel. Thank you.